Capitalism is not just another mode of economics for you to choose. There are a lot of people today who are suggesting capitalism is a tool. We'll get to that phrase in a little while. They're suggesting that capitalism is just another way that we can choose to organize our economy. And economics is not really about values. It's just about how we choose to distribute the wealth in any given economy. But that's a lie. Capitalism is about certain fundamental moral principles. Capitalism is inherently more moral than other systems. Free markets are more moral than non-free markets. Why? Because they suggest that you, as an individual, own your own labor. You are in charge of your own labor. You get to decide how you want to alienate that labor, what you wish to trade that labor for. You get to decide the value of your own labor, whether you want to, in fact, work for a given wage. You can trade your goods and services for somebody else's goods and services, making both of you richer. Contrary to popular opinion, when two people make a trade, both sides benefit. And if you're worried about the trade deficit with the person you just made a trade with, maybe you should have made a better trade on your own. Okay, but the idea that a voluntary trade is somehow a re-enshrinement of power hierarchies is a lie. And finally, the value of your labor can only be decided by other people who are also choosing freely. It's not a cram down on you, and you are not allowed to cram down on other folks. They get to alienate their labor too. They get to decide how much your labor is worth to them, just as you get to decide how much their labor is worth to you. That basic perspective is simply free. It is simply humane. It is rooted in basic truths about what it means to be an individual human being. It also happens to be wildly effective. It's a great lie that capitalism is ineffective. I mean, it really is not just a big lie. It is maybe the biggest lie of the modern age, is that capitalism is ineffective. It's such sheer unbelievable nonsense that it boggles the mind that anyone actually believes this. Really. The left seems to suggest that redistributionism has raised people from poverty. So they'll point to countries like Norway or Denmark, and then they'll say what really stopped poverty in these countries was redistributionism. Sheer nonsense. What stopped poverty in those countries was capitalism, and then they redistributed off the top. Now, you can make an argument as to whether that redistributionism is good or bad. I think the answer is that it's bad, and it's generally less effective than free markets in generating entrepreneurship, technological development, cheaper prices, the stuff that makes for better goods and services. But there's no question that the driving force behind the success of even the Nordic economies is capitalism and free trade, which is why many of the countries that the left loves to cite have lower corporate taxes than the United States and lower business regulations than the United States. The fact is that capitalism has raised half the globe out of abject poverty in the last 40 years alone.